Today, the lesson that we are going to discuss is on the use of assessment tools, that is Genogram, which is an important assessment tool for the practice of social casework method. This lesson focuses on Genogram as a tool for assessing problems in family patterns and relationships. The aim of this lesson is to familiarize with the concept of Genogram, its utility and basic steps for constructing a Genogram. It also has attempted to throw some light on the interview which are conducted to collect information for the purpose of drawing a Genogram. Now let's look at some of the objectives which are being set for this lesson. First, clearly state what is the concept of a Genogram. Then secondly, explain the types of information which are being recorded in a Genogram. Thirdly, to describe the purpose of constructing a Genogram. Fourth, to gain familiarity with the symbols and different lines which are used in constructing a Genogram. Fifth, to identify the steps which are involved in drawing a Genogram and constructing a Genogram. Lastly, to realize the importance of interviews for constructing Genograms. So now that we have seen what are the objectives, so now let's see the concept of Genogram. Murray Rose invented the concept of Genogram as a part of his family systems model in the 1970s. Although Bowen laid the theoretical foundation for the Genogram as a diagram of underlying the emotional process in the family, intergenerational family therapists have been credited for advancing the practical use of the Genogram as a diagnostic and therapeutic tool. So, Genograms were later developed and popularized in the clinical settings by Monica McGoldrick and Randy Gerson through the publication of their very famous book titled Genogram in Family Assessment, which was published in the year 1985. So, Genograms have now become a widely used assessment and therapeutic tools by professionals in various fields, not only in social work, but including other fields such as counseling, psychology, psychiatry, medicine, then genetic research, education, and many more. So, Genogram is a valuable assessment tool. It is a pictorial representation of a person's family tree. So, it is a format for drawing a family tree that records information about the family members and their relationships over at least three generations. So, diagrammatically, the Genogram is an intergenerational map of three or more generations of a family and a primary assessment tool that focuses on intergenerational patterns and relationships among the family members. It has been widely promoted as a useful tool for gathering and recording and displaying family information in order to practice family-centered care. It represents a large quantity of complex family information and can effectively illustrate family data, family history, family systems, and intergenerational transmissions. As a visual assessment tool, the Genogram can be used to trace family influences in various contexts as well as in the broader system. Genograms have been used to help practitioners understand the family context, to trace behavior and problems of family members, and to identify patterns and issues within families. While understanding dysfunctional patterns, it is essential for treatment, and identifying strength is also the foundation that directs intervention. Genogram presents a mechanism of identifying the strengths and resources of individuals and families within a life cycle framework. What are the different types of information which are being recorded in a Genogram? Genogram, it is a graphic representation of a family that provides valuable information about the family structure, that about family data, family history, family relationships, and the changes that the family has gone through over a period of time. And there are three broad categories of information which are being represented in a Genogram. The first one is about the family structure. So, it includes the family members, So when we say structure, we mean as to who are the people who are belonging to that family. In the family structure, we represent those family members among whom there exists biological as well as legal relationships. It also includes family members who are already dead, divorced and separated. It also includes significant others, such as a live-in partner and a significant non-family member who has either lived with the family or has impacted the family by playing major roles in the affairs of the family. It basically represents all the nuclear as well as the extended family members from at least three generations. And to represent these different family members, there are different symbols which have been used. Then going to the information about the individual family members. Here, information about the family members includes details about each of the family members. It includes their demographic data, such as their birth date, the year of their death, year of the marriage, year of separation and divorce. It also includes their educational and work profile, the occupation which they are holding at present. It may also include information such as their personality characteristics, their medical problems. If they are suffering from any kind of problems, then that is also being recorded in a genogram. Then information about their emotional and behavioral problems are also recorded. Then the third category of information which is being recorded, it is about the family relationships, that is the patterns of relationship which exist among the family members are also depicted. So this is done by the use of different lines. The different types of relationships that exist among the family members are being represented. So the patterns of closeness, distance, hostility and conflict and estrangement among the family members in the various subsystems are being represented in a genogram. So now that we have seen the different types of information which are being recorded in a genogram, let's move ahead to understand what is the purpose of drawing a genogram. So genograms can serve as a multi-generational assessment tool for understanding family functioning and family processes. They are used extensively in clinical practice with families. They are especially useful from a systems perspective. Genograms helps the social workers to locate the family members in relation to each other with a view to detecting family structures and patterns of interactions among the family members of at least three generations. Genograms provide family information graphically in a way that it provides a quick understanding of complex family patterns and a rich source of speculation about how a problem may be connected to the family context and the evolution of both problem as well as the context of the problem over time. It is a systematic and comprehensive assessment of a family through time. It makes it easier to keep in mind about the family members, about the family patterns, the level of cohesiveness, and events that may have recurring significance in a family's ongoing care. The genogram provides an efficient clinical summary, allowing a social worker who is unfamiliar with a case to grasp quickly a large amount of information about a family and to have a view of potential problems. While notes written in a chart or questionnaire answers may become lost in a clinical record, genogram information is immediately recognizable and can be added to and corrected as each home visit as more information is learned about the family. So it allows to quickly capture the information regarding the family of the client and identify problematic areas and also the scope for interventions. It saves the time of the social worker who may need to immediately start working with the particular client. Thus, in a very short duration of time, a genogram provides valuable and also voluminous amount of information about the client and his or her family structure, patterns, as well as relationships. Genogram is a very versatile clinical tool that helps social workers to integrate the family information of a client for the problem solving process. And as in when new information about the client and his or her family are being brought into light, the social worker can easily update the information either by altering with the old notes or by adding the new ones. So this saves the time and efforts of the social worker, and the social worker does not need to rewrite everything again and again. Genogram is a family diagram which maps relationships and patterns of functioning of a family, which helps the professionals to think systematically about how events and relationships in the client's life is related to the patterns of problems that he or she is facing. It helps the social workers in identifying problem areas which may lay in the family structure and the patterns of interactions among the various family members. Genograms can also help the family members to see themselves in a new way and are thus an important way of joining with families in therapy. They enable a worker to reframe, detoxify, and normalize emotions-laden issues, creating a systematic perspective which helps to track family issues. It helps both the worker as well as the family to see the larger picture, both currently and historically, that is the structured, relational, and the functional information about the family on a genogram can be viewed both horizontally across the family context and vertically through the generations. That is, from a genogram, we can assess the present pattern of the problem existing among the different subsystems of the family, that is horizontally, and can also assess the problems which have been transmitted or carried over from the generations, that is the vertical assessment. The genogram can highlight both current as well as historical family patterns to illustrate the dysfunctional family structures and relationships. On the genogram, we include the entire family members, nuclear and extended family members, as well as significant non-family members who have ever lived with or played a major role in the family's life, and a summary of the present family situation, including relevant events and problems. Current behavior and problems of the client and other family members can then be traced on the genogram from multiple perspectives. The index person, or the person with the problem, or the person to whom we refer as the client, may be viewed in the context of various subsystems such as siblings, complementary and symmetrically reciprocal, and in relation to the broader meta systems such as the community, social institutions, and the broader socio-cultural context. By scanning the family system historically and assessing previous life cycle transitions, one can place present issues in the context of the family's evolutionary patterns. So, patterns of previous problems and earlier shifts in family relationships brought about through changes in family structures and other critical life changes can easily be noted on the genogram, providing a rich source of hypothesis about what leads to change in a particular family. Thus, the genogram usually includes at least three generations of family members, as well as information and critical events in the family's history, particularly in relation to the life cycles of the family. Genograms can also act as an exceptional tool for encouraging insight and awareness of the client into his or her personal family issues. As work with the client progresses beyond assessment, the genogram becomes an intervention tool also, with insights derived from the observation about the patterns and relationships among the members of one's own family. The client assumes responsibility for moving towards increased identity clarification within family context. As individuals engage in person-to-person relationship with members of his or her family, they become more differentiated as they become aware about the pathology of their own problems existing within their family environment, and thus they also become more ready and willing to take part in the process of intervention. They become more aware of their own self as well as the family patterns and relationships existing among their different family members, and thus they become more willing to invest and participate in the helping process. Let's look at the different steps which are involved in creating a genogram. Three different levels of creating a genogram. The first one is for mapping the family structure, then second one is recording of family information, and finally the third one is delineating family relationships. So we have various symbols and lines which are being used in the creation of a genogram. Creating a genogram is a step-by-step process needing the social worker to collect information about the family of the client. These symbols and lines are universal in spite of the fact that various professionals in different fields may make use of the genogram in their professional practice. So the genogram is drawn in one single sheet of paper. The various steps involved in the creation of genogram as briefly mentioned earlier. Now let's look into details. Focusing on the first one, for mapping the family structure, various symbols are being used, and these various symbols, square basically represents a male and a round figure represents female person. Then the index person. Index person means the client. If it's a male person, we draw a square. So if we are representing a client who is a male, then we have to draw a small square within the square. Then in case of a client who is a female, we have to draw a circle again within the circle. So this is how we represent the clients. Then in case of the birth date, we represent the birth date on the left of the symbol. Above the symbol on the left side, we write the birth date. Then in case of the death date of the person, it is usually written on the right side, above the symbol on the right side. Then we also mention what is the age of the person. At present, what is the age? So the age of the person in terms of years, it is represented in the middle of the symbol. And this is how we represent. Apart from this, in the genogram, we also represent about the marriage and the relationships. So a husband is represented with a square, then the wife is represented with a circle, and these two figures has to be joined. After joining the two symbols representing the husband and the wife, we write M dot, the year of marriage. Another important thing while representing separated couple, what we have to do is we cut the line. So one single cut represents that there has been a separation. So in case there has been a divorce, what we have to do is we write small m dot the year of marriage, small s dot the year of separation, and then small d dot the year of divorce, and two cuts. In a genogram, we can also represent pregnancy, we can also represent abortions and so on. These are the various symbols which are used by the social worker to represent the various members of the client's family. Now that we have discussed the first type of information which are being recorded, let's move to the second category of information which is being recorded in a genogram, and that is about the family information, recording the family information. So, after the basic structure of the family has been drawn, the next step is recording of information regarding the individual family members and the family events. So, demographic information such as the year of birth, the year of date, age, year of marriage, separation or divorce, educational and professional details such as educational qualification, the job position that the individual members holds or held, and annual income, then personality characteristics such as being open, accepting, traditional, friendly, social, etc. Then medical problems which the individual have or had, for example, problems such as asthma, cancer, insomnia, blindness, etc. Then emotional and behavioral problems, for example, anxiety, depression, attention seeking, hyperactive, etc. and so on. So, all these are noted against each of the symbol of the respective family member. All the information related to an individual are recorded around the symbol which represents that particular person. Critical events that has occurred through the life cycle of the family are also recorded. The information about such events are recorded on the left hand side of the genogram. The critical events are recorded in the chronological order of its occurrence with the mention of the year of the occurrence of the event and a brief mention of the event. So, this was about recording of family information. Now, the final step in constructing of the genogram is delineating family relationships. So, in this step, different lines are being used to represent the different patterns of relationships between the family members, and these different lines representing the intergenerational patterns between the individual family members, and we have to use these lines to connect the different symbols. In case, for example, we are using three bold parallel lines, then it means very close relationship, okay? That means these two individuals are very closely connected with one another. In case we use two bold parallel lines, it means there is close relationship between those, then a zigzag line represents that it is a conflictual relationship. So, these are some of the very significant lines that can be used in representing a genogram. So, now that we have looked at the three steps which are involved in drawing a genogram, let's look at interviews, which is very essential for drawing a genogram. The information about the client and the family is basically collected through interviews. So, we usually gather the information about the family from the client. Sometimes the client may not be in a position to share all the complete information, and for that we need to keep in mind that the objective is not in drawing a perfect genogram, but rather to gather the essential information for the comprehension of the situation. The interview should take place in a relaxed and a secure environment, imbued with empathy, a non-judgmental attitude, and a positive consideration for the client by the social worker. The important element to consider in the creation of a genogram are the interviews, the social worker's abilities in carrying it out and organizing its contents, the order of the collection of the data, and the nature of the information and the representation of the information. All these are very, very essential. The questions required to create a genogram must be adapted to the context and also to the age of the client or the person from whom we are acquiring the information. So, there are some examples of questions for a married person who is having a children as to what type of questions we can ask. Tell me about your present family situation. What is the occupation of each of the parents? their date of birth, their religious affiliation, their nationalities. Then, how many children do you have? What are their ages, sex, their order of birth, etc.? Then, who lives under the same roof with you? Where do the other family members of the family live? What is the reason for their departure? So, these are some of the examples of questions which we can use while interviewing a person in order to collect information so that we are able to construct or we are able to draw a particular genogram. Let's summarize. So, what we have learned is that the genogram is an essential assessment tool for social workers to assess the family of the clients. It is a useful tool that can be adapted to many different settings and circumstances. Genogram has been used as a tool for assessment while working with various problems such as marital conflict, sexuality related problems, treating alcoholism, issues with step families, families with violence and conflict, issues of children and adolescents, and so on.